Beautiful. Let's have a nice round of applause for her. Let's say again. That was just wonderful.
Give it up.
Excellent. Wonderful, wonderful.
You know, Telemiracle Dollars have helped a lot of people over the years, and we have had a lot of stories over the years that have been on Telemiracle in the past. A few years ago, there was a great story from Annika. Let's check out where she is now.
Okay.
Annika is 7 years old. She's in grade 2. She's in a French immersion school and thriving there. She's doing wonderful. She's got so many friends, 2 siblings, an older brother and a younger sister. And they enjoy doing lots of things together, baseball, swimming. She likes to do anything and everything her brothers and sisters are doing. Annika has what's called quadriplegia spastic cerebral palsy that affects half of her body, her right side more than her left, and it affects her legs more than her arms.
Annika wants to be like every normal child. She wants to do the same chores her siblings are doing. She wants to do the same sports they're doing. She sees no reason that her disability should stop. The equipment that we required to really help Annika in her life was the Bruno chairlift. It allowed for her to be able to transfer herself from her wheelchair to the van to be lifted in. By using the Bruno chairlift, she felt like she was like everybody else in her family. She's able to get in and out of the vehicle herself.
I think the Kinsmen Telemiracle Foundation really gave Annika independence, mobility, dignity in being able to do things that other people take for granted. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart.
Hi, I'm Jason Warren, and this is my daughter, Annika Warren. Annika was a recipient of Telemiracle in 2015.
I'm in grade 9 now, and thanks to Telemiracle, I now have some of the strength and confidence I need today.
We really want to say thank you very much to everybody who's given in the past and gives today and gives into the future. Your help and your donations have provided so much to us. Thank you very much.
What a wonderful piece and a wonderful update. Thank you so much, guys. Now, somebody that is very special to me, but also to Telemiracle, and he's not here. He's usually coming across this stage with his cowboy boots on and his cowboy hat and all, you know, garbed up, is the one and only Ray Neeland. I got a chance to sit down with him back in January. Take a look. Ray, you know, remind me, how many years is this that you've been involved with Telemiracle?
It's getting around the 23, 24, I guess.
Well, we, you know what, we appreciate you helping out Telemiracle every year. You're someone that, you know, I look up to as a person of how you give back, and you're so selfless of yourself, even if you're going through things yourself. If you're going through troubled times, either horses or your health, you never let anybody talk about that. You just want to always focus on what you can do for Telemiracle, and that you are a very special person for doing that. You have to know that, right? Do you know that?
Thank you very much. I do appreciate it. And shucks, I just love doing it. And thank you.
It would not be Telemiracle for me if I did not get to see our friend Ray, my favorite cowboy. Ray, how are you?
Really great right now, I'll tell you. I'm getting by, you bet.
I know you are. You're always getting by. Ray, you have been involved with Telemiracle, well, a little bit longer than me. Your first Telemiracle was Telemiracle 20, and I think I was 21, so you beat me. Mm-hmm. How did you get involved?
Well, I had been watching on TV the Telemiracle thing for a number of years. And then one year, Noreen, my wife, she says, let's go into Martinsville. There's a mini Telemiracle going on. So we did. And they had entertainment. They had people explaining how they'd been helped. Well, when I heard them people explaining how it helped them, that got me by the hind leg. And man, oh man, I thought, there's something worthwhile doing.
And that you have been doing, I think, over the years. I remember all these things you've done. You had a thing called the Pony Express, and then you sold almonds, and you said that went over really well at the rodeos because people were hungry there. So you grabbed them. You grabbed their money. That was good, too. Then you'd do your the gas sale, the gas cards. You'd raise a lot of money doing that. But it couldn't have happened if it wasn't you, the one person making all of that happen. What did it mean for you to do that?
I didn't do it all myself. Lots of people helped too, but I was the one that come up with the ideas. Yeah, it just seemed to run right. The ideas popped out of my head. And because I never ever, like growing up, didn't think I was very smart or anything. I did very poor in school. And
all I can say, Ray, is you're very special. You're a very special person.
Thank you.
Over the years, you have raised over $465,000. Like, that's incredible, all right? But we're here today because you have a significant personal donation that you have made this year. Over $141,000. Mm-hmm. This is your personal money.
Well, shucks, yeah, well, when it's gonna help so darn many people, I couldn't help but do it, yeah. And I'm very proud of being able to do it, and it's just.
I'm proud to call you my friend, and you're a friend to Telemiracle, and we couldn't do this without you.
Thank you.
It takes people like you
to
make
you.
All of this happen, so thank you, Ray.
Well, I'm glad people like you are doing this to give us a chance to also help.
Thank you, my friend.
Boy.
What an incredible man. I know, Ray, you're out there watching right now. Of course you are. This is your Telemiracle. But I know that was from your home. That was the sale of your home and a lot of your money. And you wanted Telemiracle to have it. And I just, we can't thank you enough. I do have to tell everybody that over the years that he has been fundraising and doing things for Telemiracle, Ray has been a part of raising $606,000. That's unreal. You are special to me, my friend, and special to every one of us, and we could not love you more. Thank you, Ray.
I have to say, you might not be able to see it from home right now, but there are a lot of us that are pretty choked up about that. That is such a special thing, Ray. We're so proud to call you a friend of Telemiracle. Thank you. This next song, I think this is right up Ray's alley. I think that he would really like this, so it makes sense. Let's welcome Maurice from Prince Albert to sing Working Man Blues.
And I think are we going to the tape of Maurice now?
What I have here, but maybe there's been a change.
Maybe there's been a change. I was so moved by this story. Here we go.
It's a big job just getting by with nine kids and a wife. But I've been a working man, dang near all my life, and I keep on working. Long as my two hands are fit to use. Drink my beer in a tavern, sing a little bit of these working man blues. I keep my nose on the grindstone, work hard every day. Might get a little tired on the weekend. After I draw my pay, then I'll go back working. Till Monday morning, I'm right back with the crew. I drink a little beer that evening, sing a little bit of these working man blues. Sometimes I think about leaving, I do a little bumming around. Wanna throw my bills out the window, catch a train to another town, then I'll go back working. Gotta buy my kids a brand new pair of shoes. I drink a little beer in the tavern, sing a little bit of these working man blues. Here comes that working man. I working man blues. That's your song of the working man.
We are that again, and we support Telemiracle because we are rooted in Saskatchewan.
Shouting out from Lanigan. Woo! Hello. Lanigan.
Yeah,
hello,
thanks for
Lanigan.
Doing that.
And if you're in Lanigan, please call in a donation on behalf of those folks. Now, Brad, we're here with a couple groups who brought in some donations. We have the first one, I believe, is coming in. Actually,
oh, first, let's do a knock.
You know, we realize we got to get some phones. We got to get some phones
they're
ringing
sitting
here
in the
before we go
line,
any further.
The back row is not working right now.
Yeah, so we want to make sure
around.
We keep the phones ringing right through the end of the show now. So if you're not on the phone, please stand up.
Not on the phone.
Okay.
And come on, Saskatchewan. Let's get on those phones.
There's not a lot, so that's great, Saskatchewan.
Lunch is over. It's time to get back to work here.
We've only got about 3 hours and 45 minutes left in the telephone.
We don't have much time.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, my gosh.
It's going to be Sunday afternoon.
This is going to take no time at all.
347-2022. Dial in. Don't wait till that last hour that a lot of you want to do.
Saskatchewan. Just 4 phones left.
That's right, come on. And go to telemiracle.com, 347-2022. We want to take your donations any way we possibly can. Big or small. Four phones left, Saskatchewan.
If you were as moved by Ray's story as we are, please call in.
Think about Ray. Think of the giving
right.
he did.
Bella wants you to ring those phones.
Let's go.
Two more to go, Saskatchewan. Two more to go. Help us out. One more. 347-2022. Call and go to telemiracle.com. Click the donate button.
Go.
Hey, thank you so much. And we have a total.
Let's check it out.
Help us out with these numbers. Ooh.
2 million. Fantastic.
So
we have some on-air presentations here. That
we do.
Like
we have
do.
Some on-air presentations. I believe the first one is coming in virtually.
I think so.
So we're gonna hope that happens. And I believe we have Melody Freeze on the line here. We're gonna find out here, Brad. And if we don't get that, we can go to the group we have coming
we
on
have
the side of the
Robert
stage.
Robert on the side.
Yeah. So let's just wait a second and see if we have Melody.
There we go.
Melody, we're just making sure we have everything lined up here. Is this Melody Freeze?
Yes.
Hey, Melody, it's great to have you with us. Where are you? Where are we speaking to you from?
Kindersley.
Hello, Kindersley. And I believe you have a donation to tell us that is on behalf of someone near and dear to you. Is that right?
That's right, yes.
So, yeah, go ahead and tell us about your the story and the donation, please.
The donation that I'm presenting is on behalf of my father, in memory of my mom. She passed away just about a year ago now. The donation is $105,698.89.
Oh my goodness! Let us pause there for a second. We need a round of applause for that here. That's fantastic. Yeah. Thank you so much. And that was her name was Joanne, right?
Yes, I'm sorry. Yes.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful. And did you have anything else you wanted to tell us about Joanne while you have a moment here?
Absolutely. So, Mom and Dad were very involved in Kinsmen and Canets. I grew up a kin kid. Spent the years that Telemeric was in Saskatoon, quite when we were in there, and us kids in the audience on our best behavior, of course, while Mom and Dad were answering phones or whatever. Mom was a very generous spirit, and on her passing, this was one of her wishes. So it feels really good.
Oh, beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. I can tell it feels good for you. I can see the emotion. I can feel the emotion. Like you're here. I want to give you a big hug. We are so grateful here that Joanne thought of doing this, having the kin life, you being a kin kid, and giving that big donation over $100,000 to Telemiracle 46. We are grateful. Thank you very much for doing that on behalf of Joanne. Can't thank you enough. That is absolutely wonderful. So have yourself a great afternoon, and thanks for spending the time with us, right?
Thank you very much.
Thanks so much. We're going to hand it over to Brad.
Okay, thanks, Jeff. We have some more on here. Come on out here. We have Robert Purvis, and he's coming out here to give a presentation, and he also has a friend. Turn around here, face the cameras. Yeah, and you're Robert.
Yes, I am.
And you hail from, where's your home?
I'm here from Regina.
Right here in Regina, so you're nice and close to home. Thanks for coming out today. And your name is?
Christina.
Hi, Christina. How are you? Great.
She's like a support worker and a friend of mine.
She looks like a good friend to have. Hanging out with her, yeah, for sure. So what do you have today for us?
I'm Robert. This is for my family. Okay. In memory of my mom, Sadie Haas, who passed away. And we're challenging all foster homes in the Saskatchewan to meet or beat our pledge of $200.
Awesome. Very good. Thank you very much. Robert, you did a good job. $200. Thanks for coming out today. We really appreciate you being here. And maybe next year you can come back.
Hopefully.
Okay. Thank you so much. Appreciate
thanks.
That. Have a great day.
Fantastic work. Fantastic work.
Thanks, Robert.
Head over to
thanks,
Jess.
Thanks, Brad. Aw, that's so fun. Thank you guys for being here. We want to remind you guys again one more time just where those dollars are going. So let me tell you a little bit about Brady Bourne. Can you imagine being a self-employed father of five who unexpectedly loses the loss of his legs? We can all imagine how difficult that might be, and that's where Telemiracle is more than happy to help. Let's meet Brady.
My name is Brady Bourne. In the summer of 2020, I started to have some back pain. They discovered that there was a tumor in my spine, and I was operated on. They removed the tumor, but unfortunately, the operation left me paraplegic. One of my first concerns when I woke up from surgery was, when I knew that I was a paraplegic, was wondering how I was gonna pay our family bills. I am a father of five. Being a self-employed contractor, going from working full-time to not being able to run my business anymore was my biggest fear. I spent 8 days in RUH in recovery from surgery, and then I spent 8 weeks at City Hospital Rehab. It was brought up that I was going to need a wheelchair to take home. This wheelchair was a game changer for me. Considerably lighter than anything I'd ever used before. It's much more maneuverable, much more comfortable.
Brady having a chair that works well for him and Brady having the BaTeC means that he can go do some stuff with the kids without me having to be there every time. It gives us a lot of our normalcy back.
The BaTeC will take me on walks with my kids. It will take me on journeys down the beach. It'll take me downtown to be able to pick up milk. There's a lot of possibilities that I haven't even thought of yet. Life is definitely different now. It's adapting to new struggles that we never thought we would encounter. I'm not afraid of the future. It's definitely different than I expected, but I look forward to it.
I think that might be my favorite quote of the entire weekend so far, is that Brady saying he is not afraid of the future. It's a little bit different, but they're ready. And I think we're ready. I think that we actually have Brady and his family on the line. Hey guys, I'm so excited to meet you. How are you?
We're good. We're excited to be here.
Amazing. I see all five children. Why don't you do a quick little run around? Who is everybody?
So we have our oldest Decker here behind me, and then Layla is here. We got Rowan over here, Solomon, and then Waverly.
Amazing. Hey kids, does your dad let you kind of drive around in the BaTeC? Because it looks pretty cool. Nope, that is just dads. I totally get it. Brady, that must allow you so much more freedom than you ever thought.
It absolutely does. Yes, it's unreal how it's extended my range of mobility and my reach within the town is so much larger now.
Yeah, no kidding. I love that you can put the front wheel on as well. How long does it take you to convert that into a trike? Like, it looked from the video like it took probably 4 seconds. Is it easy to do that?
Yep, that is all it is.
Wow.
What shows on the video there is all it takes.
Man, that is absolutely incredible. Well, thank you for sharing your story with Telemiracle. We are so happy. We are just as excited for your future as you are. So thanks again for joining us today and for sharing your story.
Thank you for having us.
Nice to meet you. Over to you, Jeff.
Thanks so much, Jess. You know, it's really funny that you singled out that quote. And is it, I'm not afraid of the future?
That's exactly what he said.
And you know, the first time I heard Brady say that in the video, I literally stopped myself and I thought, I'm going to have that Brady quote in my head for the rest of my life, or try. It's perfect. And you know, the wheels, the device you talked about, it just changed their life, you know?
Absolutely, it did.
It's really incredible. All from funds raised right here at Telemiracle. Now, Telemiracle has had a longtime friend that a lot of you recognize. He was with the telethon for many, many, many years, and his name was Mr. Bob McGrath. And we all got to meet Bob many times, and we enjoyed spending time with him on the stages of Telemiracle, backstage. He has an incredible sense of humor. He is such a kind soul. He was such a kind soul when he was here with us doing the telethon. And looking back through some past footage of previous shows when Bob was with us, our producers found some great moments with Bob, including a clip of him speaking where we thought he summed up perfectly what Telemiracle is and represents. It became part of Bob's fabric, much like it's become part of yours. So let's take a look at a little look at Bob from the past here. Here we go.
Love can make miracles happen. Miracles happen when good neighbors think about and love and respond to other neighbors that are in need. And that's what's been happening throughout this province for the last 30 years. Now, oftentimes we use the word, you know, the phrase, oh, it was a miracle. We kind of throw that about. But this morning at a production meeting, I want to tell you something. We had a testimonial from a young single mom with a 15-year-old son. And this is a true miracle, because she said, I was supposed to be dead by next month. And it caused us all to pause and stop. But because of your incredible generosity last year at Telemiracle 30, it not only didn't happen, but she was able to go to a specialist down in Seattle, Washington, with her brother, who was a perfect match for a bone marrow transplant, a very delicate and long operation and recovery for almost 6 months. She said that if she had not been able to go to the Kinsman Foundation, and if they hadn't taken care of all those expenses that are not covered, she would have had to not only deplete her entire life savings, but she would have had to sell her home as well. She didn't have to do that. And the reason she didn't have to do that is because last year, all of you here, all of you throughout the entire province, kept these phones up here busy for an entire 20 hours. And that's what we're asking you to do right now. You're probably within an arm's reach of a telephone. So just remember that your phone sitting near you and this bank of telephones out here, that's the lifeline, a real honest to goodness lifeline that helps children and grandparents and your neighbors and your friends, and for those who you'll never meet, but some who may be very close to you. And that's what Telemiracle is all about.
Wow. Bob McGrath, a legend, a gentleman, and a friend of Telemiracle, and he summed up so perfectly what you can do by picking up your phone right now and calling in a donation. You heard how he described how the donations changed that gal's life, and that these donations are literally a lifeline for people. We're looking forward to your lifeline before the end of the show in a few hours. Thank you so much. What a great time looking back at Bob, too. I'm going to throw it over to Kyla.
Hello. All right. So I believe.
Hello.
Oh, hello. Say hello to everyone.
Hello.
We're back.
Casual Kyla and Bella Brave.
What?
Bella decided she did not want her wings anymore, so here we are. Just a little bit more entertainment for you as we carry on. So I believe I'm going to be able to speak with a Jordan from Assiniboia.
Yeah.
Oh, there she is. Hello.
Hi, Jordan.
How are you doing today?
I'm good, and you?
We are doing great.
Yeah, great.
Yeah. So, I believe you have performed for Telemiracle in the past.
Yes.
Is that right?
Correct. I've performed on Telemiracle 44 and 45.
That's wonderful. Thank you for that. And what will you be showing us today in your video?
I'll be performing an original song called Daddy's Girl. This song's about leaving home, but keeping your hometown in your heart and staying attached to your roots, which coincidentally matches really well with this year's theme.
That absolutely works perfectly with our theme of rooted in Saskatchewan. Bella, what would you like to say to Jordan before we see her clip?
Why do you like to dance?
Oh, she's gonna be singing.
Why do you like to sing?
I love to sing to reach people and connect with people and their emotions.
Okay, and we would love to hear about your donation for Telemiracle.
Okay, this year, the Assiniboine Kinsmen and myself did fundraising through a Beef on the Bun, accepting personal donations and an auction. The Beef on the Bun raised $682.50. The auction and 50-50 raised $11,182. We received personal donations, which raised $1,815. And the total we are pledging today is $13,680.
Wow.
Wow.
Earlier this fall, though, we sent in personal donations worth $240. And the grand total from the Assiniboine Kinsmen and myself is
$13,920.
Oh my gosh. Wow, that's a lot of money.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Okay, let's go to your video.
That's beautiful.
So beautiful. Thank Jordan you Engstrom. So much, Jordan.
Jordan Engstrom, Daddy's Girl. Love that. Love that. And as you've been talking a lot throughout the telethon, Jess, how the Saskatchewan talent we have, there's so much this year because we know people love tuning in to watch that.
Yeah.
They're an integral part of the telethon, but another integral part of what makes Telemiracle happen and make those results so big are our corporate sponsors.
I knew you were going to say that, Jeffrey.
You're in my mind.
We do know that Nutrien is matching all of the Sask talent donations up to $100,000, but there are so many more corporate sponsors that we have to thank.
Right, and we have some who are actually, they brought in donations at other times in the telethon, but right now they're answering the phones behind us, so we're going to give them a quick thank you for double dutying it on the telephones.
Yes.
Who do we have here to the far stage right here, Jess?
We've got kind of just Harvard Broadcasting here. We've got Play 92, The Wolf, CKRM, Ralco Radio, and my favorite part is that you don't, we have much more. We have CTV.
Mm-hmm.
But my favorite part is that you don't know who you're going to be talking to when you call in. So you might even be talking to Gloria Evans. You know, you could be talking to your
favorite, radio celebrity. Exactly. So we've got Harvard here. We've got Ralco. We've got CTV. So we want to give a big shout out, big thank you to local media for doing all that, helping make the telethon go. We're going to pass it over to Mr. Brad Johnner for something else here.
Thank you very much, guys. I have a very special gift for Telemiracle. Shirley was born as Shirley Hind in 1935 to her parents, Thomas and Mildred Hind, and grew up on a farm at Pence, Saskatchewan. One of Shirley's brothers, Ronald, passed away in infancy, and another brother, Calvin, passed away in 2010. Shirley taught school for 32 years in the Indian Head, Saskatchewan school unit. Those who knew her described Shirley as caring, thoughtful, a grand lady, and a good friend. Shirley loved children, and in her last few years, she especially enjoyed spending holiday times with her cousin Alan and his wife Diane and their grandkids. Shirley is survived by her brother George Hind, as well as numerous cousins who miss her dearly. Shirley passed away in 2018. Kinsman Telemiracle would like to thank Shirley for her generous gift of $155,574.33. Isn't that something?
That really is. Wow.
Wow, that's a big chunk of her life savings right there. And we really thank Shirley and her friends and her family for sending that donation our way. And I would like to mention that Shirley had passed away 4 years ago. So planning your gift, it takes a little bit of time. So it's nice that when people think ahead and they plan their gift to Telemiracle, that it can take place on the stage like it has. So once again, thanks for that huge donation from Shirley Ann Pryor.
We have another amazing instance of planned giving. This one is via video, a very special video of Brian Watson.
Hi, I'm Linda Norman, and this is my sister, Judy McConnell. And we also have another sister, Diane Burton, but she was not able to make it today. She's in Edmonton. Our father, Brian Watson, was born October 4th, 1932, and he passed away November 10th, 2020. Dad grew up and lived on the family farm in the Dinsmore area for most of his years. He loved being a farmer. In 2005, he was proud to receive the Century Family Farm Award. Dad was a kind, loving man with a great sense of humor, and family was very important to him. He loved to golf in the summer and curl in the winter, and all year round, he loved his coffee roll. Dad was very active in the community of Dinsmore. There were many boards and projects that he was involved in over the years. He certainly was not afraid to step up to the plate and help out. Both Mom and Dad were members of the Dinsmore Kinsmen and Connect Club, and in their later years, the K40 Club. Very few district conventions were missed, and television was always turned on during Telemiracle. We are very proud to present this bequest of $150,000.
Brian, Thank you, Brian. And what a beautiful, beautiful story told by the family. And then, and prior to Brian's donation, we had Shirley a similar amount. It's incredible to see that generosity.
It is just mind-blowing for me, the generosity, but where the money comes from, and it's right here from people in Saskatchewan that knew how important it was to leave this money to TeleMiracle, because they're taking care of their neighbors,
people
their
right
family,
here in the province.
Right.
That's right.
Here.
It's beautiful.
Oh, I love it so much. All right, so these phones ring, and then there's some funny requests that come in, and sometimes we try to get to most of them. So here's one that just came in. So Corby Kirby, if you're watching out there, Corby Kirby is in Swift Current Hospital. He's a boy with special needs and has requested that if I, Beverly, say hi on air to him. His donation says $10 or $100, so he'll go to $100 if I say hi to him on air, and I will do just that. So Corey Kirby, it's me talking to you. Give us your $100.
Give me $100, Corey. So there.
Yeah.
And there's an extra $100 for that kiss she blew.
I want another little bonus. All right, now I have one other thing that I've got to do, and I've kept this in my pocket. So my girl Jess, we've been hanging out here kind of, all weekend, and she's seen me run around with this thing in my hair, okay? And so she said, okay, Beverly, because I got under a truck, and she said, okay, Beverly, if you wore that on TeleMiracle, I will make a donation of $500. So, Jess?
It's that. I'm very proud of you, Beverly. I'm on it. Let me go get my purse.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to wait right here for it.
Love it. Love it. Love it. Love it. Love it. Love it. Now, what's coming up here next, Beverly? I mean, I think we're keeping the show rolling. We're ticking down to the total, the final total. We only got a few hours left. What's next?
Got to keep it rolling. Well, how we keep that rolling is you're also somebody very special here to TeleMiracle, even with my clip in my hair. This is our very own Jeffrey Stryker.
Maybe I didn't love you quite as often as I could have. Maybe I didn't treat you quite as good as I should have. And if it made you feel second best, oh, I'm sorry I was blind. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. Maybe I didn't hold you all those lonely times, and I guess I never told you I'm so happy that you're mine. Little things I should have said and done, oh, I just never took the time. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. Tell me that your sweet love doesn't die. Keep you satisfied. Little things I should have said and done. time. You were always on my mind. You're always on my mind. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind.
Right, I think that might be my new favorite Jeffrey song. Loved it.
Beverly, I was singing every note right to you.
I felt it. I knew you that. Just knew it.
Oh, you know what? I think, singing the songs, people stop and watch the songs, but we want them to keep calling in, and they are.
They are.
And because they've been calling in,
I think we've got a total.
Yeah,
gonna
so we're gonna see where we got to here. Help us out with the numbers.
Come on, Saskatchewan.
Here we go.
Say it with us.
Two, one, three, five, four.
Are coming together, and you are here. Joan's here representing the town of Nokomis, and it says on your shirt, a small town with a big heart, and you've been on Telemiracle before.
Yes.
And I understand that your check amount has changed a couple of times today already.
Yes.
Okay, what do you have for us?
Can I read my thing?
Yeah, read away.
I am here on behalf of the town of Nokomis with a population of just over 400 people. This year, we raised money a few different ways, Helping Hands at the Credit Union and the Co-op Grocery Store, bringing in $109.50. Nokomis School, that is a K-8 with 54 students, held a pancake breakfast in Helping Hands, raising $165.50. We held an online auction with the items from businesses and individuals from Nokomis and surrounding areas, which we raised $5,093. We also received online personal donations totaling $3,778. As my shirt says, we are a small town with a big heart, as a few people in our community has benefited from Telemiracle. I want to thank everyone for making our first year a success, as I had a last minute donation, making my check higher than what was on my check. I am happy to please present Telemiracle with a check for $9,146.
$9,146, even more than a check amount. And this is the first year
for the town of Nokomis.
Well, Nokomis, we're going to be hounding you now. You've worked so hard to help us this year. We hope you're on board again next year.
Thank you
very much, Joan. Appreciate that.
That's fantastic, Brad. That's unbelievable. Small town Saskatchewan, right? Everybody pitching in, everybody helping out. This is Louise from Meadow Lake Canets, and tell us how you raised your money.
So we had an online auction for a week, and we raised $6,219. So businesses and individuals donated items, and so we just did that way. Flying Dust Fuel, the customers and staff donated $304.80, and my family donated $500, for a total of $7,023.80.
$7,023.80. And introduce your friends.
From the Canets is Julie and Allison.
All right. Thank
you. We're a small club. We only have six in our club.
Six members in the club, 5,000 in Meadow Lake, and we raised $7,023.80. Thank you, ladies. Fantastic.
Wow. Yeah. Round of applause. That is a small but mighty Canet. Way to go. Thank you, ladies, so much. Well, we are going to take it over to Cut Knife now, I believe. I think we have Janika on the line.
Sorry.
Janika, are you with us? Awesome.
Yeah.
Hey, am I saying your name right? I grew up with the last name Moskaluk, and would you believe it? No one could ever say it. So I want to make sure I'm saying your name correctly.
Janika, yeah. You're
awesome.
Doing great.
So glad to hear it. And you're calling from Cut Knife right now?
Yeah.
Perfect. Tell us a little bit about what you're going to do for Telemiracle today.
So I'm singing the song Rise Up by Andra Day. I the song lyrics are really about, like, the past year with COVID and everything, you know, we lost a lot of people. And, you know, I lost a lot of close family members to COVID. And Tell a Miracle, it is different with the online and everything. So, you know, the song Rise Up is really about rising up from all the losses and all the COVID. And, you know, we just got to keep going.
So this song has a special place in your heart.
Yes. Yeah.
Amazing. Well, we are very excited to hear it. Is this your first time performing at Tell a Miracle?
No, I've sang in the past before when I was like a teenager, but I became a mom now, so.
I love it. Well, we can't wait to hear Janika singing Rise Up right now. Thank you, Janika.
When you're broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round and you can't find love.
Janika from Cut Knife, Saskatchewan. That was absolutely beautiful. She started singing and she stopped me right in my tracks. I've been up to the Cut Knife area a few times, so a big shout out to the folks up there in Cut Knife. Remember, when your talent is singing those songs like that, please keep your phones, your fingers on your phone, dialing and calling a donation. And I'm going to go to keep the theme going with talented folks here. We've had a fella who's performed on the show already. He's going to perform again, but we've not had a chance to speak with him yet, so we're going to take a little second to talk to Mr. Jake Vodeland. Jake, it's great to have you here live to get to chat with you here for a second. If I'm not mistaken, are you from Cut Knife as well?
I am also in Cut Knife right now as well, and in fact, I know Janika. I went to school with her, not in the same class, but I know who she is.
Well, how fantastic is that? We've kind of got the Cut Knife segment on Telemiracle right now. Now, Jake, we've seen some of your songs earlier in the show, and fantastic performances. You and the band you have backing you, I think you call it, is it the Sturgeon River Boys? Have I got that right?
Yes.
Yep. And I know, I mean, one of your songs that I know and I'm a fan of, it's Retro Man. It's kind of your signature song these days. And I see you're dressed up in your retro garb. And as your song explains, that's not just for look. It's something you do. Tell me, was this your first time performing on Telemiracle? Was this your first time?
It's my first time with the Sturgeon River Boys. I have been on Telemiracle twice before with my old musical partner. His name is Ira Amundson.
That's right. He was the banjo guy. That's right. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, it's cool to have you back. I love the talent you're bringing to the show with your band. It's been really enjoyable. Loving what you've done. And I think you're going to help us cue up your next number for us here. Can you tell us what it's called?
It's called House and Pool.
And is this is an original song you wrote, Jake?
An original song of mine. Talks a little bit about my passion for what I want to do as a musician.
Love it. Love what you do. Love what you're bringing here to the telethon, helping those phones ring. Great chatting with you, Jake Vodeland in Cut Knife, Saskatchewan. Here we go with Jake's next tune.
House and Pool. You know, I've been on Telemiracle a few times now.
with my friend Ira Amundsen, and I believe both of my parents have been on there as well, so it's a good cause, so remember to ring those phones.
Jake Fodlin from Cut Knife, Saskatchewan, representing that neck of the woods in the province. If you're up there from the Cut Knife area, please call in a donation. We've got about 3 hours left in the telethon.
Gosh, is
I know.
That it?
Time's a ticking. And thanks,
we're
Jake.
Running out of time
thanks,
to call.
Jake. Thanks, Jake, for the great performance with the Sturgeon River Boys. Now, Jess. So Jake has performed multiple times through the telethon. You being one of the hosts in the show, you're also bringing some performances to the stage, I believe.
I'm really excited.
And I think we get to have one of your songs coming up. Maybe you can tell us a little bit about what the tune is.
Yeah, this one is really exciting and special to me. This was actually my very first number one single at radio, which is appropriate with some of our friends at radio answering phones right now. So if you are, maybe this is my challenge, if you are a country music fan and you support females in country music, then I can think of no better way than to donate whatever you can to Tell a Miracle.
I thought your challenge was going to be if you're a country musician song. Who's had a number one hit, which is nobody.
There are lots. Maybe just not.
No, I love the challenge. So just remind us of the name of the song and kick her off here.
Yeah, this is me singing Country Girls.
This is me. I love it. Here we go.
Jess Moskalou, great job there. Standing here with a fella that was born and raised right here in Regina. This is just.